Hello, I'm Raina Yadlapati, a third-year gastroenterology and hepatology fellow at Northwestern University Feinberg School of Medicine in Chicago, Illinois. And I have the pleasure of sharing our work entitled Identification of Quality Measures for the Performance of and Interpretation of Data from Esophageal Manometry, which will be highlighted in the April issue of Clinical Gastroenterology and Hepatology. Now, with the shift in value-based healthcare, there is an increased emphasis on quality measurement. We've learned that in esophageal manometry, performance and interpretation practices vary significantly, and this can result in misdiagnoses, poor patient outcomes, and increased healthcare costs. Thus, the aim of our work was to define quality measures for esophageal manometry. Now, some things to keep in mind are that quality measures are unique from guidelines. They define aspects of care that are considered absolutely critical to providing high-quality patient care. They're held to higher standards than guidelines, and if a physician, for instance, does not adhere to a quality measure, they may be considered to be providing suboptimal care. When experts define quality measures, they're supposed to do so regardless of cost and feasibility, and measures are intended to apply to the average patient at the average institution being seen by the average physician. So in this process, we utilize the RAND-UCLA appropriateness method, which I'll refer to as RAM moving forward. RAM is a well-described method that's been used to develop quality of care measures across a wide variety of disciplines. First, we performed a literature review and generated a list of 26 potential quality measures. At the same time, we recruited an expert panel by inviting 15 esophageal experts from across the nation. They consisted of gastroenterologists and GI surgeons. And in the end, 14 accepted and participated in the entire process. Prior to getting started with the RAM methodology, we gathered baseline data about the experts' performance patterns and found that variations in practice exist even amongst these experts from centers of excellence. So in round one of RAM, the experts independently ranked each potential measure for appropriateness based on a scale of 1 to 9, 1 being highly inappropriate and 9 being highly appropriate. Experts were instructed to rank based on their personal judgment and were also given the opportunity to reword measures and propose new measures. After round one, our study team analyzed these measures for agreement and appropriateness, and then the measures and rankings were discussed at a round two meeting, which was hosted in Washington, D.C. in May 2015. Prior to round two, our study team compiled a packet of literature review summaries and ranking summaries, and the experts reviewed these packets prior to our meeting, and the packets were also provided at the round two meeting. So in round two, all the measures were discussed, debated, reviewed, and then re-ranked again for appropriateness. Finally, our study team performed a final analysis and found that 17 potential quality measures were ranked as appropriate with high agreement. 2 related to pre-procedural, 3 were procedural itself, and then 10 were combined into one composite data interpretation measure. In addition, there were 2 measures that related to competency. And competency was a topic of great discussion during round two. All panelists agreed that technician and interpreter competency is of utmost importance to a high-quality manometry study. However, currently, we do not have a standardized method to determine competency. So, defining these key 8 quality measures is an important and needed step in esophageal manometry. Our hope is that these quality measures will be incorporated into national quality measurement reporting systems and that all physicians and institutions can adhere to these measures. Particularly, all motility labs performing esophageal manometry should adhere to our pre-procedural and procedural quality measures. And all manometry reports should include the details outlined in our composite data interpretation quality measure. Importantly, this work highlighted the critical deficiency in our understanding of competency requirements and has led our team now to investigate learning curves and competency benchmarks for esophageal manometry. This collective work has important implications on physician practices and quality of care that we deliver, and we'd like to thank the AGA for the opportunity to share our work with you. Thank you.